Okay, I did my little video about my 84 Cooey the other day, and I figured I'd do another Canadian gun, or another Cooey anyway, and a little interest, I guess, to my Canadian viewers. For most Canadian shooters that are probably over 30 or so, I guess, these are a fairly well-known gun. They're probably not as well-known as they once were, because Cooey's been shut down for quite a while, but this is the Model 60 Cooey. 22 repeater. It's a bolt action. I started out when I was about 5 shooting, and I started out with like a Model 39 and a Model 75 Cooey, and they're just single shots. And then when I was 10 years old, I got one of these, a Model 60. Not this one here, but this is a more beat up one I got later, so I kind of dragged this one in the woods more kind of deal. But and it's, you know, for a 10-year-old, this is quite an upgrade from a single shot to a 22 repeater. Like, the firepower is just insane compared to, like, a single shot. And for a little kid, that's, you know, it's, you know, you have quite a lot of fun with a gun like this. Yeah, wasting ammo. But it'll hold, I think it's 11 long rifle, I think you can get into it. You can get 10 in the mag and probably 1 in the barrel. Like 15 short. And longs, I'm not sure, but it'll handle all the different those three cartridges, the short, long, and long rifle. And the longs are probably, I don't know, 12 or 13, somewhere around there. Probably a few extra than the long rifle. But it's the Cooey guns, like this is the Model 60, so it's still built by Cooey. When Winchester bought out Cooey, they went to a Model 600. But the Model 60 was built somewhere around between, like, I think it was 1939 or 1940. And then Cooey got bought in 61, but I think Winchester kept the Model 60 going for a few years until it was at the mid or late 60s they changed to the 600, but I'm not too sure. Give you a little close-up of the action and stuff. A very simple little bolt action. There's the mag follower. This one has holes for a scope mount. Earlier ones didn't have that, so I think this one might be built like in the late 50s or the 60s even. I have one nut here to take the stock off. Your mag, tubular mag is here, and just pull it back, and then you just put the rounds down in here, and then put the follower back. It's got fairly rudimentary sights on it. But it's, you know, these are really, really solid built gun. They had pretty decent wood in them. They usually had walnut stocks on them. And just a steel butt plate. It has, this one has a safety. You can push the bolt up in here. And there's also, you can put it on half cock if you want. But whatever. They're really a really good gun. Like, they're very positive. They have a large double extractors, like spring steel extractors there. The shell is fed up from below, and then they grab onto the shell very well. I've never had like feeding issues or anything with any of these guns. They work very, very well. They're just a really, really great gun. But that's pretty much what all the Cooey guns were like. They were quite inexpensive, but they've worked. They wouldn't really let you down, but there was nothing, no frills, you know, but they were a solid gun. Like, they weren't cheap or anything, weren't flimsy feeling, and they were very, very accurate. You know, like, the with these kind of sights here, you can't really expect super accuracy, because you got a sort of an open kind of U sight here, and the front's kind of a blade that's been sort of shaped on the sides and make it look like a bead. And those, like, for hunting and stuff, those are a perfect type of sight. But when they put a scope on this, they'll shoot like incredibly well day in, day out. They have very, very good barrels on the Cooey guns. But they're just overall a great Canadian gun anyway. But there's a lot of similar ones that were built in the States. Like, there was It's just insane how many different kinds of like 22 repeaters and single shots and stuff that were built in the States and there. But this was one that they, you know, it sold very well in Canada. I don't know if the Cooey's, I think, were probably a little bit cheaper than some of the ones built in the States. And I guess in the old days, a lot of Canadians would buy this before they'd buy something that was built in the States, but you know, you kind of understand that, and you want to have a national pride with their own stuff. But they were a really good gun anyway. Like the, it seemed like everybody that was younger, you know, older people, they always, their first gun was always a Cooey, like, and some people that was their only gun, like they, some people all they had was like a Cooey 22 or a Cooey shotgun. You know, as like I mentioned in the other video there, and Log Cabin Looms up to, left a message, he said, you know, people had rifles, but everybody had a shotgun. Like, that's incredibly true. Like, pretty much everybody in the world, in, you know, Canada and the States that had a gun, they, like, everybody had a shotgun, pretty much, it seemed, because they were just so much, and a 22 as well, like, they're just so useful of a gun. Like, there's not much you can't kill with this. Like, you can hunt everything, small game and up, and people shot deer with these friggin' things, you know, like, and they've, I've heard of people shooting moose with these way back, it would have been the earlier Cooey's, but the, between the wars, there was still a few moose floating around in this province. Most of them are all up north now, or the northern parts of the province, but in the old days they were, I think they closed the season in 33 or something, but before that there was quite a few moose in the mainland part of the province here, and people would shoot friggin' moose with 22s. They'd just shoot them in the lungs or whatever. And they would wander around for a while, but they'd, you'd get them, so. So you'd show a 22 is a, you know, is sort of underpowered as a lot of people think it is. It's an incredibly useful cartridge and gun, so. Anyway, this is a little blurb about the Model 60 Cooey, and it's one of my favorite guns. It was basically my first gun I ever got, so it's probably my, in that way, be my favorite gun. Anyway, thanks for watching.